Email 1 subject, how yoga helps you stay flexible in pregnancy. Dear, name, yoga is an exercise philosophy that just about anyone can perform, including those who are pregnant. In fact, there are so many benefits yoga provides to pregnant women that you can make it a must in your daily routine. Yoga can be adjusted to your needs and be as complicated or as easy as you need it. You can even benefit from just doing 5 minutes a day. There are plenty of yoga classes designed for pregnancy called prenatal yoga. Prenatal yoga improves flexibility, mental focus, and breathing to prepare for delivery. It can make it easier to push and be more mentally prepared for what is to come on delivery day. It can also increase strength and reduce anxiety to make the next 9 months more comfortable. Benefits of prenatal yoga: improved sleep, reduced stress, reduced anxiety, increased strength, controlled breathing, less pain in the back and groin, increased flexibility. Flexibility is necessary to discuss because it is what leads to most of the benefits listed above. Lack of flexibility is usually responsible for pain and discomfort. How prenatal yoga increases flexibility: provides consistent stretching of certain muscle groups. Many yoga positions are stretching exercises that warm up and work for specific muscle groups. These stretches also require precise moves and holds that build strength, therefore, increasing your flexibility. Reduces psychological and physical stress. Psychological and physical stress can cause many problems throughout the body. As you do each pose, you will be instructed to concentrate and focus on your body to help release this stress and be more connected to your body. Relieves pain. Pain is usually associated with inflammation and excess fluid in the body. Yoga warms and provides strength to these areas to relieve pain. With the many benefits that prenatal yoga provides, there is no reason you shouldn't get started today. Find some local classes or look on YouTube to get started. Make sure you contact your doctor to be sure that you are not doing anything unsafe for the baby. Next time, we'll look at how yoga helps to stay flexible when you are overweight. Email 2 subject, how yoga helps you stay flexible when you are overweight. Dear, name, if you are overweight, you may have some concerns about starting yoga. Yoga requires the ability to move and bend in ways you may feel you can't achieve. However, being overweight should never stop you from doing yoga, or anything for that matter. The benefits of yoga: to gain weight, you have to take in more calories than you are burning. So, it is likely those who are overweight are just too inactive, and a great way to solve this is by moving. Yoga is a great option, especially because it can be changed to suit your physical needs. Yoga is more than just physical exercise. Yoga is a way of life and can bring mental clarity as well. Many yoga sessions incorporate poses as well as breathing techniques and static holds. While you are holding each position, instructors will tell you to be aware of how you feel so you can build strength within your body and mind. Not only will you decrease your weight and improve your mental health, but you will also build strength and improve your flexibility. Flexibility is essential because it provides the range of motion you need to avoid injury while completing everyday tasks. Overweight people often lead a sedentary life, which can make joints and muscles tight, stiff, and sore. As you practice yoga, it will warm up these muscles and joints and release toxic chemicals that promote inflammation and pain. Shavasana. Even mental clarity can improve as your body becomes more flexible. Depression and stress wreak havoc on the body that most people don't even notice. When practicing yoga, one of the main goals is to reach Shavasana. Many yoga sessions will end on this pose, which is merely laying down and searching for peace. Many use this time for meditation and to reach a state of nothingness. As you release the pressures of the world, you can de-stress and release inflammation and toxic energy from the body. This ultimately leads to more flexibility and better health overall. Those who are overweight will benefit significantly from yoga in so many ways. Don't let it stop you. Find a yoga class today. Next time, find out how yoga helps athletes stay flexible. Email 3 subject, how yoga helps athletes stay flexible. Dear, name, yoga is a philosophy and form of exercise that anyone, including experienced athletes, can follow. Athletes can significantly benefit from yoga, even if they think they are incredibly fit and healthy already. One of the most potent and helpful benefits athletes will get from performing yoga is added flexibility. The average person requires flexibility to perform everyday tasks. If you lack flexibility, you will likely notice and want to fix it. Flexibility is the ability to move and bend in a wide range of motions easily without injury or pain, to achieve specific tasks. Having excellent flexibility for athletes means they can run farther and extend their bodies more than the average person. How yoga helps athletes stay flexible, increases power. The slow and precise yoga positions will activate new muscles that even the most experienced athletes may not be aware of, leading to increased muscle strength and power. Improves endurance. Yoga poses require precision and proper breathing that will, in turn, improve your endurance. As you do each yoga pose, you will hold and breathe through the position. Improves balance and posture. As you increase your muscle strength through holding each pose, your balance and posture will improve. Many athletes, especially runners, have improper postures and balances as time goes on, so it is imperative that they incorporate exercises to fix it. Improves focus. As stated previously, yoga is more than just an exercise, it is a philosophy to live by. Many yoga classes focus on the pose along with the mind to connect each and to be aware of how your body is feeling. At the end of the session, you will do Shavasana, which is the final pose of peace and acceptance. The more mindful you are of your body, the more your focus will improve. Increases range of motion. Slow, controlled movements warm your muscles and releases tension from your joints to allow an increased range of motion. Reduces stiffness and soreness. Many athletes experience sore and stiff muscles from overworking. Yoga reduces this by warming up the muscles and releasing toxins from the joints. As you can see, even the most experienced athletes can benefit from yoga. Flexibility is just one of many benefits. You will also benefit from yoga because it provides a great space to relax and release any extra stress that is likely to come from being an athlete. Flexibility is especially important when you're older. In our next email, we'll look at how yoga helps the elderly stay flexible. Email 4 subject: How yoga helps the elderly stay flexible. Dear name, unfortunately, the older we get, the harder it is to accomplish daily living activities. Getting out of bed, getting water, and even proper hygiene can start to feel overwhelming. This is why it is crucial to start an appropriate exercise routine before you begin to experience problems. However, if you are already experiencing a few uncomfortable things, it does not mean you should give up. This is where yoga comes in. Yoga incorporates poses or stretches that require a wide range of motion, precision, and control. Anyone at any age, including seniors, can benefit from and do yoga. Yoga can be practiced at home, and you will likely also be able to find sessions specifically designed for the elderly. An essential benefit of yoga is increased flexibility. Flexibility is what makes daily and more challenging tasks easier to perform. Improves stiff or achy joints. The control and precise postures required in yoga help release stiff, achy joints. As people sit, certain toxins can build up that cause inflammation, making it more difficult to move around. These exercises and stretches effectively warm up the stiff joints and muscles. Tone supporting muscles. Yoga exercise tones muscles, which helps to prevent injuries and falls. When performing yoga exercises, typically, you will need to hold the position for an extended period of time to build strength. Reduces depression. Depression can prevent you from being flexible and make you feel unwell. It puts a strain on your overall health and mental clarity. Since yoga also involves practicing a philosophy of peace, it can help improve your mental health. Improved balance and stability. The more you perform the poses in yoga, the more your muscles will build strength. This added strength will allow you to develop balance and stability. This, in turn, helps reduce the chances of falls, which is a common danger to the elderly. Increasing your flexibility can solve many health problems and make it easier to get around as you age. Find a class near you to get started. You can even find live stream classes on the internet so you can stay inside and be safe. We've talked a lot about the need to stay flexible, but did you know that there are also foods that can make you feel more flexible? We'll look at that next time. Email 5 subject: Foods to eat to make you more flexible. Dear name, Believe it or not, you can change your diet to increase your flexibility by incorporating or eliminating different food groups. While exercise and stretches are essential to increase flexibility, your diet is just as important, if not more. Certain foods can hinder all the hard work you are doing. So, it is vital to create a diet plan specific to your goals, so you don't prevent yourself from achieving them. Experts say it is 80% food and 20% exercise, so don't skimp on creating the right food plan. Anti-inflammatory foods. By far, the most important food group to pay attention to is anti-inflammatory foods. Any food that may cause you inflammation should be eliminated. Inflammation is one of the most significant factors that prevent flexibility. Food that creates inflammation includes unnatural sugars, processed foods, gluten, saturated and trans fats, and refined carbohydrates. Berries, greens, and turmeric are all options that help reduce inflammation. Hydrating foods. Add as many hydrating foods as possible to your diet. This includes water-rich fruits like watermelon, peaches, grapefruit, and pineapple. Water-rich vegetables include cucumbers, zucchini, and celery. Amino and essential fatty acids. This includes omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids found in flax seeds or fish. Watermelon is an excellent source of amino acids too. Other ideas include fatty fish, walnuts, lean meat, grains, and beans. Sulfur-rich foods. Animal proteins, eggs, and vegetables such as broccoli and cabbage are high in sulfur. Sulfur-rich foods are essential to your diet because they promote connective tissue health by providing sulfur-to-protein bonds that develop flexibility. As you can see, certain foods are extremely important to your diet, while others should be eliminated as much as possible. Inflammatory foods, unnatural sugars, and processed foods can all contribute to an unhealthy body that prevents you from being flexible and in optimal health. Make sure you add sulfur-rich, hydrating, and nutrient-dense foods to your diet for the best results. Not only will you become more flexible, but you will also become healthier overall and may even lose some extra weight. Next time, we'll look at how stretching exercises can help improve flexibility. Email 6 subject, stretching exercises to improve flexibility. Dear, name, one of the most surefire ways to increase your flexibility is through stretching. If you don't stretch, it is unlikely that you are very flexible unless you were lucky enough to be born that way. Flexible people should understand the importance of stretching, as they can often overextend themselves. Proper stretching releases tension and increases blood flow to allow more oxygen to go to the muscles. It also helps warm up muscles before exercise to prevent injuries. Stretching helps with flexibility because it elongates the muscle fibers and tendons. Sedentary people will benefit significantly from just adding simple stretching exercise to their day. This is because your body gets used to the range of motions it does each day and will adapt to it. The more you sit around, the less likely you are to engage certain muscles, and after a while, your body will adapt to this, making it harder to move around later. This can easily be improved with stretching. Before you start your workout or if you would just like an excellent start to your day, try these popular stretching exercises. Butterfly stretch. This stretch requires you to sit down with your feet together. Place your hands at your ankles, sit down in your hips, keep your back straight, and move your knees into the floor. Your arms can be used for extra tension. This stretch is perfect for your inner thighs, groin, hips, and knee muscles. You can watch this video to learn how to do it correctly. Lunging hip flexor stretch. Start this stretch on both of your knees. Take your right leg and extend it out in front with your foot flat on the floor. Place the palm of your hands on your thigh and then rock forward and hold for 30 seconds to stretch. This stretch is great if you sit a lot to stretch out your hip flexors. Click here to learn more. Knee to chest stretch. This stretch is best to relieve stress from your back and hips. Start in a seating position in a chair. Take your left leg by placing your palms under your knee and then lift up towards you while breathing in. Watch this YouTube video to learn more. Triceps stretch. The triceps stretch is great for your arms and to build flexibility. Start by standing straight and lifting your left or right arm straight up. Then bend at your elbow backward to where your hand is at your back. Take your other arm and apply pressure back to stretch. Click here to watch a video on how to do it. Stretching does not need to be difficult or intense. It is always a great idea to take it slow and stop if there is any pain. Make sure you speak with your doctor before you try anything new if you have a medical condition. In our next email, we're going to look at how dance can make you more flexible. Email 7 subject, how dance can make you more flexible. Dear, name, dancing is not only fun, but it is liberating and said to be one of the best types of exercise there is. There are no limits to dancing, which is why so many people love it. You don't need to have a rhyme or reason to dance, you don't even need rhythm, just a willingness to move and have fun. One of the many benefits people experience is added flexibility. Flexibility allows you a wide range of motion without injury or discomfort. It provides stability when performing everyday tasks. The great news is if you are not very flexible right now, you can change that through stretches, exercises, and dancing. Bridge. This type of stretch requires you to bend backward and to arch your back. Advanced dancers can do bridges from a standing position. Beginners can start from a lunging position. Here is an excellent video for beginners. This stretches the chest, neck, spine, and hip, making it perfect for increased flexibility. Oversplits. This type of stretch is best for advanced dancers. It requires a hold of at least 30 seconds to loosen ligaments around the hips and knees to increase flexibility, and is best performed with an instructor. Barfit. Barfit is a traditional ballet class that combines elements of fitness. The focus is to lengthen, tone, and stretch muscles. Many exercises require focus and balance to center or align the body. The stretching and slow movements are how increased flexibility is achieved. Ballet. This is similar to bar fit without the fitness elements. Ballet is great for flexibility due to the wide range of motions and intense need to control every muscle in the body. Each move is delicate and requires precision. Contemporary. This dance type requires high energy and over-the-top expressions to master. It was made to wipe out the constraints of ballet, while still building strength and elongation of the limbs. Find out if there are any dance classes in your area to increase your flexibility. You do not need to be a professional dancer or have any experience at all to find dance classes. You can even start in your home by finding professional how-to videos on YouTube. Next time, we're going to look at how Pilates can help to make you more flexible. Email 8 subject, how Pilates can make you more flexible. Dear, name, Pilates is a form of exercise that increases core stability, strength, and flexibility. It is a unique form of exercise that concentrates on more than just the exercises alone. It involves mindfulness of the whole body. Pilates relies on the principles of concentration, centering, precision, alignment, flow, and integration to receive full benefits. This means that Pilates exercises will be slow and precise to encourage one to focus on the body as a whole, while being mindful of its movements. Dynamic stretching. Dynamic stretching releases muscle tension and other stress found within the body to increase your range of motion. The more your muscles are stretched and the higher your range of motion, the more flexible you will become. Strength and stability. Pilates focuses on a balanced body. This includes strength, balance, and flexibility. Without strength and stability, you won't have flexibility. The slow and controlled exercises used builds overall body strength to improve stability and flexibility. Static holds. Exercises in Pilates are slow and controlled and require static holds. Static holds are when you do an exercise and then hold it for a specific period of time and do your best to not move from the position. You must also pay attention to your breathing and make sure you are controlling the position correctly. The more awareness you have of movements and the more control you have, the more flexible you can become. As you hold each exercise, you are building strength and mindfulness while increasing your body's abilities. Slow and controlled exercises used in Pilates is a great way to increase your flexibility. You can always find free classes on the internet through YouTube, but it is still a great idea to join a class first. This way, you can be sure you understand and execute the exercise correctly and safely. Pilates will not only make you more flexible but will also make you more mindful of your body, which can help reduce stress and make you healthier overall. Next time, we'll look at the benefits of massage when you want to be more flexible. Email 9 subject, how massage can make you more flexible dear, name, if you are looking for more ways to increase your flexibility without stretches and exercising, then massage is your answer. Sometimes it is nice to let others do the work for you, and getting a massage is one of those ways. Massage can work your muscles to help loosen them up as well as release lactic acid that is responsible for reducing your range of motion. Massage allow for more mobility and reduce your chances of injury and experiencing pain. Types of massage. Deep tissue massage. This type of massage relies on deep pressures on soft tissues. The amount of pressure applied depends on what a person can handle. Deep tissue massage releases muscle tightness and tension that prevent flexibility. Sports massage. This type of massage is intense and relies on increasing the temperature of areas containing soft tissue. The goal is to reduce pain in certain areas, which in turn increases flexibility. Therapeutic massage. This type of massage relies on manipulating muscles by using certain techniques. While the other two types of massage rely on pressure and can be intense, the goal for this type of massage is to promote relaxation both physically and mentally. Typically, you will want to use less pressure to reduce the chances of pain. Deep strokes. This style of massage requires firm pressure and long strokes on affected areas. The goal is to create friction and pressure to increase blood flow. Kneading. This requires pulling and squeezing on the affected areas using the fists. As you apply pressure, you move hands up and down as if you are kneading bread. How massage increases flexibility. Increasing muscle temperature. Massage warms up the muscles to help loosen and relax them. An increase in the temperature of connective tissue is vital to improve elasticity and flexibility. Breaking down adhesions. When injuries happen, collagen fibers appear and are hard for extra protection, which ultimately reduces movement. Massage breaks down and realigns collagen fibers to soften them up to improve muscle elasticity and mobility. Releasing toxins. When muscles are massaged, toxins such as lactic acid are released. These toxins can cause inflammation or make it hard to move around. Reducing swelling, inflammation, and pain. One of the key factors that can prevent flexibility is inflammation or swelling around your joints and muscles, which can result in painful or tender areas. Massage effectively loosens these muscles and encourages blood flow to reduce any swelling and inflammation. The next time you get a massage, you won't have to feel guilty because you thought it was an unnecessary treat. Massages are far from extravagant. They not only feel great but are also incredibly healthy for the body. Kids need to stay flexible too. Look out for some exercise ideas in our next email. Email 10 subject, flexibility exercises for kids. Dear, name, flexibility is essential for overall health, so it is a good idea to get your kids started early. Improve joint stability, prevent injuries, and reduce muscle tension in your kids by simply getting them to do easy exercises or stretches that focus on flexibility. There are many ways your child can increase their flexibility, but the following exercises are easy and fun. Child's pose. Starting on a yoga mat, kneel on your knees with your back straight and legs just as wide as your hips. Then start to lean forward, lowering your chest onto your thighs and forehead on the mat, leaving your arms close by your side. To get more of a stretch, have the kids reach their arms up. Watch this video from HowCast to learn more. Cobra pose. Have the child start on their belly with their toes straight out and nose to the floor. Put their palms on the ground close to their chest, and fingertips spread out. Start the pose by pushing up, lifting their head while pushing down on their feet to keep them down. Once in this position, they can raise their arms to make it more challenging. Watch this YouTube video to learn more. Rocking plank. Have the child start on their stomach. Then lift their body with their toes and forearms on the ground, keeping their back and butt straight, not high up in the air. Then rock by moving forward and back to build their arm strength. Have them try to hold this position 15 to 30 seconds at a time. Watch this YouTube video to learn more. You can even make exercises into games that your kids have probably even played before. It only takes a little bit of imagination to get them going. Limbo. This is by far one of the most popular and fun games for kids, and it is one of the best ones to help with flexibility. It relies on the kids bending backward a little and walking under a bar without touching it. They cannot use their hands or crawl under. Each time they go under without touching, the bar goes lower. It builds the strength of their muscles as they go under. Your kids will never get bored as they try harder and harder to do the lower levels. Simone says is a game that requires you to tell the kids what to do by saying, Simone says, followed by a direction. Then the kids follow up by doing what Simone says but only what Simone says. If you don't include the phrase Simone says, the kids shouldn't do it. If they do, they are out of the game and whoever is left wins. Incorporate the stretches you learned above to make it about exercise and increasing your flexibility. Don't let your kids miss out on the many benefits that flexibility brings. Start them off right and implement these easy exercises and games today. The more your kids incorporate exercise early, the more they will benefit later as adults.